I look like a real YouTuber now.
Oh my god, this makes such a difference.
I am like, wow. Look at this makeup.
Plop! Hello dolls, it's me, Babs, your favorite ultrasound tech or sonographer. If you've never seen me before, I am an OBGYN sonographer, so I mostly just scan women. I am so excited because look at my backdrop. And before we get started, I already know there's something going on around here. I think it's my setting powder. It's not translating very well through the video. So just bear with me. Try to ignore what's going on here and just take in the information that I'm giving you. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. Today we're gonna talk about the first trimester screening. All right, so you're around 11 to 12 weeks. Congratulations, you made it this far. So the American Pregnancy Association defines a first trimester screening as an optional non-invasive evaluation that combines maternal blood, maternal age, and a screening test with an ultrasound evaluation of the fetus to identify risk for specific chromosomal abnormalities, including trisomy 21 or Down syndrome and trisomy 18 or Edwards syndrome. Now this gives you the risk, not a definite yes or no that your baby has one of these syndromes. It's gonna give you a number like 1 out of 100, 1 out of 1,000, 1 out of 500,000, something like that. To get a definite yes or no answer, you need a diagnostic test like a CVS or amniocentesis, which are performed at different times of your pregnancy, but usually only one is done. So when is the first trimester screening performed? It's usually done between 11 and 13 weeks, but because the length of the fetus is more important than the actual age, it can be done as early as 10 weeks or as late as 14 weeks. Now this measurement is called CRL, crown rump length. We measure the crown, the top of the baby's head or the top of the fetus head, and then the rump, the little tushy. If the fetus measures below that cutoff, then it's too early for this exam and you need to come back. If the baby measured above that cutoff, then it's too late and you need other diagnostic testing. So that reminds me, I'm going to just bring up a little story time that's related to this video. It has nothing to do with me. No, no, no. I had this one patient come in for the first trimester screening. She and her husband came in and she was very, very adamant about the conception date, about the time that she conceived, basically the day that she had sex. And this was not an IVF pregnancy. IVF is just in vitro fertilization, meaning she went to a fertility clinic. Usually you know the exact day that you conceived because they put in the fertilized embryo or the fertilized egg inside and implant it inside your uterus. But anyway, that's not here or there. She didn't have an IVF pregnancy. This was a natural occurring pregnancy and she was so sure of when she conceived. But the menstrual period that she gave me did not match up with how many weeks she should be if she's here for this exam. So I explained to the patient, oh, listen, by the way, based on your date, you're more like 9 weeks, which makes it too early for this exam, but you already had an ultrasound with your doctor and your doctor sent you here, meaning she saw that you were measuring a lot bigger, as you should be, because we only do this exam around 11 to 13 weeks. So she asked, how can it be any bigger? And this was before I even scanned her, touched her, anything. I told her, well, if the baby is measuring 11 weeks and not 9 weeks, that means you conceived a lot earlier than you thought. And keep in mind, I'm a professional, I'm not thinking anything of it. This happens all the time. People come in, they think they're a certain amount of weeks, but they're really a different amount of weeks. And we change the due dates all the time, depending on how big the discrepancy is. So I scanned her and the baby measured 11 weeks and I was able to do the exam. When I told her that the baby measured 11 weeks, she was like, well, how can that be? I am so sure of when I conceived. And I just said, well, the measurements don't. And she finished my sentence for me. She said, lie. The measurements don't lie. My imagination could have just run away from me, but as soon as that sentence came out, a light bulb just turned on. Oh, well, okay.
Now, I'm not saying there was something shady going on. I've had patients be concerned about the baby's measurement and be so sure about the conception date, but usually that's when the baby measures less than expected, meaning they probably ovulated later, so the baby was conceived later. But she seemed so concerned and so sure about the date that she had sex, wanting me to give her an explanation I could not give, that it just struck a chord in me. I'm not making assumptions. Maybe she was just confused about the dating, or maybe she's just fickle.
And I didn't want to look at them anymore because I didn't want to give anything away or have them think that I'm thinking something, you know? So let me just repeat in case you guys are not getting it. She is very sure of when she had sex with her husband to be 9 weeks. But according to the measurements, the baby's 11 weeks and she conceived a lot earlier, 2 weeks earlier. Usually that's not a problem and the couple just go on their merry way. I don't know if it's a problem because it ain't my business. Moving on. So we sonographers have a very important job here. We need to take a fetus that looks like this and make it look like this. Because to get the measurement back here, we need a fetus that looks perfect. Just like that. Now that's not always easy. In fact, some fetuses or babies, let me just call them babies, are so adamant in staying in the position that they're in that it's nearly impossible to get that position so we can measure the nuchal fold, which is what it's called. The nuchal fold is what we measure at the first trimester screening. But we try, you know, we have to try. Some places will try for at least half an hour, some places just for a few minutes, some places might send you back the same day. So guys, not this or this, but this. This is what we need. Because a lot of the times, babies do not cooperate, there are things that we sonographers do to try to get the baby to move or change position. Number one, we move you. If you move, theoretically, the baby moves too. We turn you on your side, away from us. We turn you on the other side, towards us. We have you sit up. We have you sit back. We shake the belly. Sorry if you guys don't like that, if that has happened to you, but we shake a lot. Oh, I just realized what that looked like. Sorry. Some moms suggest doing jumping jacks. Now, listen, if you guys wanna do jumping jacks, go right ahead. I don't think they work, but if it makes you feel better, go ahead, do some jumping jacks. I think mostly people say no. I say no anyway, because it's a waste of time. Like, let's just move on with the appointment. Don't stop the appointment just so you could do jumping jacks. Drinking could help too. Cold water, soda, coffee, if you're allowed to have coffee, orange juice, pineapple juice. And one thing I wanna say about jiggling the belly, I'm not gonna make that movement again. It's kinda like creating an earthquake for the baby inside, but we are not hurting the baby. It does not hurt the baby. Do not get it twisted. We also have you cough. Again, kinda like an earthquake. We make you eat. You could have chocolate, a sandwich, anything that could get the baby to start moving, give the baby energy. If all else fails, then we just bring you back. And I'm sorry, ladies, some of you don't want to come back, but if we want to get that measurement, that perfect image, so we could get the most accurate measurement of this area, you're just gonna have to come back. Sorry. And something for you to be aware of during the exam if the baby is not getting into the position that we need. This is common. This happens all the time. Lots of babies do not want to move. As long as there is a heartbeat, which you should have been shown, or maybe a sonographer was kind enough to have you hear it, then it's fine that your baby isn't moving, because your baby is probably sleeping and comfortable and doesn't want to be bothered with. So my advice to you is, do not stress, do not freak out, do not ask, is it normal for the baby to do this? And also, if the baby is moving like a ton, do not ask, is it normal that the baby is moving so much? I understand that you probably have never been pregnant before, but even the ones who've been pregnant like 3, 5, 10 times, they ask the same thing over and over again. It's like, this isn't your first go around, lady. People always ask, is it normal, blah, 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 blah. Most of the time, yes, it doesn't matter. If the exam was performed successfully and we were able to get the nuchal fold, did I say nuchal fold before? It's not the nuchal fold, is it? If the exam was successful and we were able to get that measurement, you will be sent to get your blood drawn. The results take about a week. They go directly to your doctor or to your midwife, and that person gives you the results. We do not give you the results. We don't know what's gonna happen. We cannot tell through ultrasound if your baby is okay unless there is a major obvious issue. And while we're at it, at 11, 12 weeks, we cannot tell you the gender. Yes, there are some super special sonographers who give it a go and tell you what the gender is because they know exactly what that little area is supposed to look like at that certain time, but they could be wrong. I mean, or they could be right. It's only a 50-50 chance. But if you walk into my room, you see me as your sonographer, don't ask, because I don't know. Some of the things that the first trimester can tell us is the length of the baby, how big your baby is, like how many weeks is your baby, the heart rate, if the baby has arms and legs, a brain, and any gross anomaly or abnormalities. And I don't mean gross like ew, I mean gross like large, like obvious signs. All right, guys and girls, thank you for watching my video. I hope you made it all the way through. If you did, you're a trooper, you're awesome, you're cool, and the losers. No, I don't mean that. Anyway, hit the like button, hit subscribe. If you have any questions, leave them down below. I really want to answer them. I really want to make more videos about ultrasound. I've also been doing a lot of OBGYN ultrasounds. I really need to broaden my field of interest. So the next video I'm going to work on, hopefully, is going to be the abdominal ultrasound, or right here, the gut. And check out my other videos. They're actually pretty good. My first story time, the quality is crap, but the story is very, very good. With each new video, I hope to improve. I think I have. I mean, compare this to the first one. I mean, come on. But please check them out. They're really good videos. I worked really hard on them, and I would love it if you would just watch them and like them. So, bye guys. Ciao.